What's going on, man? All right, so, you know, not everyone's in the stream right now, but, you know, I suppose we might as well start our conversation off right now. Everyone will follow through.
All right.
So, you know, as we're both birdie players, I just wanted to kind of talk to you about, like, certain matchups and stuff. So, you know, I find that Chun-Li is the hardest matchup for birdie. Do you agree?
Yeah, I definitely agree. She's the hardest one due to how easy the game plan is for her. But definitely birdie has, you know, a couple other bad matchups too. But hers is probably the easiest one to lose against.
So what would you say is the other hard matchup?
Other hard matchups, I would say Rashid. Rashid can be really hard.
Rashid.
If he's really adamant about just staying out and never really attacking, those tornadoes, man, he gets really tough. Because then I actually practice against Layman Boy all the time in that matchup, and it gets to the point where it becomes really difficult.
Okay, nah, it makes sense. Definitely makes sense. Do you think Fang is a hard one for birdie? Because I've struggled against a very good Fang before.
Personally, I like that matchup due to the fact that he has low health. But I could definitely see on paper why it would be really difficult. Because, I mean, he's constantly just throwing out obstacles at you, right?
Yeah.
He never really has an attack. And due to the fact that birdie is such a big body, he's going to get hit by everything. I mean, he's going to get poisoned. Despite he has so much health, you know, it's time against him.
That's what I'm saying. And the fireballs is two hits. Most of Fang's normals are two hits. It's really hard to get in.
Exactly. So. Yeah, everything breaks armor. And, I mean, you need resources to fight them. You need, like, EX EX charge tackle. You need EX chain. You need EX everything to fight them.
Nah, definitely. So, who would you use in that matchup? You said that you enjoy that matchup. So, you wouldn't think to change characters or anything like that?
It depends on the player, I would say. If it's a brand new player, I would definitely opt to play birdie. But if it's against someone that I've played a lot in the past or has a lot of experience, I would probably opt to play a better matchup, you know, like play like Nash or Vega or something.
Nash or Vega? Okay. Yeah. So what other characters do you use other than birdie?
Yeah. Well, birdie is my primary. Obviously, you guys see my Alex. Still a work in progress right now. But I still plan on bringing back that Laura. I can definitely see some untapped potential in her. And I think she's definitely very underrated. And, I mean, previously we've been seeing more exposure from her, especially from, you know, Europe, like Mr. Crimson and Will Tupac.
Okay. So
I definitely think she's a really strong character for this game mechanic. And she could be really fucked up.
So you're gonna be picking up Laura, yeah?
Yeah, I think it's time to bring it back.
Bloody hell, that's a lot of characters. So you got Laura, you got Alex, Birdie. Is there any more that you got?
Nash. I mean, you said Nash. Right now, yeah, I can only play Nash. I can play any character pertaining to the matchup.
Yeah.
How comfortable I am. I mean, like, this game is very intuitive. I don't feel like you need to spend, like, years in the lab, like in Street Fighter 4, you know what I mean?
No,
like
definitely.
Find, like, specifics and everything. It's really about player to player, and it's very small in the matchup. But as long as you get the basics down and you understand and control the character properly, any matchup is possible to win, you know? Like, there's only a small handful of matchups where it's just, like, pretty much 7-3. It's kind of, like, bad. Like, Zangief probably has the most bad matchup in the game. So I can understand why people think he's, you know, bottom tier and whatnot. And it's just the character design. Like, when he was released, it seemed like, you know, he was hot shit and everything. He has the parry, the armor, cyclone, deal fireballs. But I mean, do you even have to throw fireballs at him?
Nah, it's true. Nah, it's very, very true. It's very, very true. So, do you see the Zangief versus Birdie matchup? What would you say that is? Because I think it's too much in Birdie's favor.
Yeah, that matchup is super duper free.
It's really, 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 really free. It's like, I can't see like a Zangief player really getting in. Like, it's I don't know. I just feel like it's too easy.
Like, the only way Zangief can win is if Birdie makes a mistake,
Exactly.
And he capitalized it 100%. But that's it. He only has one chance. That's it.
One chance. And, you know, if Birdie capitalizes, it's that long game of bananas.
Yeah, it's like, it's kind of like almost like playing Sagat. Almost. It's like you have to start over if you mess up, you know?
Nah, definitely, definitely, definitely. Are you looking forward to any DLC characters coming up?
Yes, I am surprisingly looking forward to Balrog. I don't know why, but I just have a good feeling about
it. Yeah, no, Balrog is going to be, he's going to be primary for me, I can't even lie.
He's going to have command grab, no charge, armor, I don't know. I'm just throwing out ideas right now.
Now, you know what, I think he still will be charged, you know? I think he'll still be charged.
He'll probably have like one charge move. Like, I mean, there's like no two charge characters in the game right now, you know?
That's what I'm saying. And I reckon he'll probably have like, you know, like a sway type of move?
Yeah, so like Karen's. Dudley or Steve
Box,
like that.
Yeah, like exactly like that. I think he's going to be really good. Are you looking forward to any other characters? Urine? Jury?
I will be looking forward to Jury. I know she comes out, at the last few months or something? Or second to last?
Yeah, I think she's second to last.
Whenever she comes out, I think she's going to be awesome. She's probably perfect for the game mechanic.
Yeah, she wasn't that popular in Street Fighter 4. She wasn't really that popular at all.
Yeah, she was, how do I explain it? She was definitely a very technical character. Very space-dependent, specific. And people, you know, they just want to pick up and play the game, right? But she requires a lot of research and study. And I felt like she was very underrated. Like, she has practically every tool to stop, you know, jump-ins, keep people out, damage output, yada yada. The only problem was she's hard to play. She has low health.
Yeah.
And people just didn't really know how to structure her correctly.
No, that's very true. It's very, 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 very true. I agree to that. So, you're not looking forward to... What about Ibuki? Because we didn't talk about Ibuki. Are you looking forward to Ibuki?
I hate that character. I have no feelings for her whatsoever. But I know there's a handful of people who are looking forward to her. And the only thing I'm looking forward to her is that if she does really well against, like, the top tier characters or something.
You know, like, you know we're going to struggle,
if
right?
She does really well against, like, Mika, Chun-Li. I'm like, okay.
But you know we're gonna struggle with Birdie, innit? Ibuki's gonna give Birdie problems. Any fast character gives Birdie problems.
I don't know. I feel like Birdie could fight her. He could probably squish her. I don't know.
Nah, I hear that, man.
I feel like if to jump up does kunai, that's like a free chain right there. Or EX headbutt. If she tries to teleport the other side, she's dead.
Nah, it's true. It's definitely, definitely true. Are you looking up for the cinematic story mode?
Oh, I completely forgot about that, to be honest.
Oh, seriously?
I'm so in tune with the game right now, and I forgot they're still releasing it.
Yeah, it's supposed to be coming out next month. You know, it's meant to be like a proper, proper structured story mode, not that free games and free fights and that's it, that crap that we had with the game.
I hope it's like Mortal Kombat X, you know, where it's like open for an hour of like cinematics, and you know it lasts for a while, you know what I mean? Like, we've been waiting for a while, so we better get some good.
That's what I'm saying, man. That's what I'm saying. So, all right, we're gonna talk more about Birdie. What type of tech, like, or should I say, what type of mind frame do you have going through like tournament matches with Birdie? With Birdie. No other character, just Birdie.
Since I'm the most comfortable with him out of all the characters that I play, I feel like with my confidence, I could really carry him really far. And on top of the fact that a lot of people, they don't have that much Birdie experience, especially in the States, I would say.
Yeah.
He's definitely a very bizarre character. Like, it's kind of uncomfortable to fight him and approach him, right? And I'm going to be using that to my advantage while I press my opponent. And, you know, I have several different strategies with him. But it all comes down to the player matchup, not the character matchup. So when I come in, I always have a plan. I don't ever feel uncomfortable with him. You know, I feel like I'm at home when I play him. Because I always know there's always a possibility to come back. And his comeback factor is humongous.
Yeah, nah, definitely, definitely. He could do a lot of damage. He could do a lot of damage.
Yeah, so if I'm ever down, I just go V-trigger, and everybody panics.
So who are the other strong birdie players in the States then? The ones that stand out.
Right now, I would say the only one I could really think of off the top of my head is probably Alucard.
Okay.
He's from East Coast. And he's been secondary birdie, not primary. But he's won a couple of tournaments with him. Besides Alucard, I would say in the States, no one, to be honest. I can't really think of anyone.
Okay, cool. Do you reckon Birdie will win a tournament, like a major?
This weekend, he's about to win one.
what tournament's happening this weekend? For the people that tell the people that don't
Combo
know.
Combo Breaker 2016 is going to be taking place in Chicago, ran by the Dark Hado, Mr. Rick himself. And I believe it has over 600 entrants?
600?
Yeah, I think it's over 600 right now.
Oh, wow.
So it's a pretty hefty amount, and majority of players are going to be from West Coast, and there's going to be East Coast players as well. But I don't believe there's going to be any internationals.
Okay.
But definitely 600 people. 600 plus is a lot.
600 plus.
The last time that number was that high was probably final round when they had over 1,000 people.
Okay. That's crazy, man. That's crazy. And you're going to stick with Birdie, yeah?
Birdie's going to be representing. You're going to see a lot of him on stream.
Boy. You know, the funny thing is, when I watch Alucard, I see that he uses Birdie, but he doesn't really, like... When the going gets tough or there's someone that's really strong, you will always go to Nakali. So that's what made me like ask you that question, because I haven't seen a birdie win like a major yet. And
the thing is, like, birdie has a lot of, well, when he has bad matchups, they're like pretty bad. You know what I mean? Like, it's just by character design. So I don't think it's really possible for Birdie to go through a whole entire tournament, run through every single matchup, and win the tournament successfully.
Yeah.
I do require that he needs like a backup secondary just to cover some matchups. But Birdie is definitely better in the longer set. If Birdie is in top 8 and it's 3 out of 5, it's good for Birdie. 2 out of 3, there's too many variables that could, you know, deter him from winning, like random jump-ins or like accidental execution. And he just dies. But if it's a longer set, you could whittle down your opponent. You could definitely get a lot of intel on them. And then from there, you just structure your game plan around it. I think Birdie is definitely one of the better characters for a longer set rather than a short set.
Oh, I kind of always thought the opposite, man. Because of his like V-trigger and comeback factor, I thought he was always like really viable to kind of like be good at first to two.
See, that's what I was thinking early stages of the game, you know, like EX Swan Dive and V-Trigger and all that quote-unquote gimmicks. But as the game progresses throughout the year and you play against stronger players who understand the character better, it's going to narrow down to just playing a really strong neutral and baiting your opponent.
Yeah.
And, you know, pretty much just waiting them out till they die. And doing it short-term 2 out of 3, like, people get really anxious, right? And they just want to go in, even when they're winning already. And then, you know what? I think that's actually a bad thing for Birdie sometimes. Because he doesn't need to do that. He never needs to overexert himself. As you can see, if you look at his physical features, he looks like a slob. Very fat. Like, he looks lazy. He doesn't have to do anything. And the best part is, when you do that, you maximize his potential, because then that's how you win a lot of matches. You just wait it out till they die. And I think that's the future for Birdie. Right now, short term, yes, V-Trigger, Swan Dives, Command Grab, you die, that's awesome. But long sets, you wait them out. It's like a boxing match. You know, you want to go through a 12th round.
Yeah. Nah, I definitely agree with you, man. Definitely agree with you. So in terms of like when you go into V-Trigger, because I ain't going to lie, even though I do win matches with Birdie, when I go into V-Trigger, I do tend to like use the bull head because of the range. Now, I know that's a big flaw with me. Like, I need to stop doing that, because people have started to discover that obviously you can punish it and stuff like that, even with the pushback. Now, what would you do? What's your angle in using V trigger, and like, what should like, what do you do when you go to V trigger? Do you do more grabs, or do you just wait it out?
Depends on how far in the match it is, how much resource my opponent has. I have health-wise, time-wise. I take all those factors into account. So say, for instance, if I could get a V-trigger and I have 70% health left, right? At that point, yeah, I could take some risk. You know, do some rubble horns, get some hits here. You know, close out the rounds. But say, if I'm closer to maybe 50 to 40% and I activate 50 V-trigger, I know my opponent's going to think that I'm desperate, right? So I'm going to take the risk and all that stuff. But really, I'm just going to hold on to that and make them preemptively, you know, do an action, a defensive action. If I were to sweep them, V-trigger, dash in, most likely they'll try to jump away, right?
Yeah, nice.
They jump away, and I get the read on that, yeah, I'll probably do the bullhorn, you know, get that one hit, you know, give them some fear into that. And once I hit on the bullhorn, I'll dash in or do a headbutt. But the thing, the interesting thing is that because he's in V-trigger mode, and his body's already covered in red, his dash animation and his light bullhorn, they look pretty similar.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So at that point, if I'm in a range to, say, sweep them, I would just dash in. They would think that's bullhorn, so they would hold down back, and I command grab them for, like, 300 damage or whatever, right? So at that point, it's already a visual mix-up, really. You get close enough, it becomes really deceptive. Because his body is covered red, so you mix up between the dash and the raw headbutts, and eventually you get to walk in for free.
Yeah.
Due to the fact that because time is against them, you have V-trigger, they're getting a hit, and, you know, the decision-making is very crucial at that point, because everything Birdie does in V-trigger is, like, high output. Regular headbutts, command grab, combo into zonk, whatever, they all do so much damage, but the thing that the opponent doesn't pay attention to most of the time is that every special move, it burns part of Birdie's V-trigger, right?
Yeah.
So, the strategy to get that is to just try to block as much as you can. You know what I mean?
That's what I'm thinking.
Block, and if you're in the range to command grab, you know, be smart about it. You know, weigh your options. Like, if he tickles you, is he going to command grab? Or is he going to do a zonk, whatever? It might be better just to, you know, jump back and take, like, a regular bullhorn combo or something. Or maybe a command grab from there. But you have to look at the situation after you get knocked down. Like, are they going to have a good advantage against you? Like, a good better okie? Or are you going to be pushed out of the corner? And you got to think about all that within a short span of the match. I know that's, like, a lot to take in.
Yeah.
But that's pretty much how my thought process is.
So don't you think, like, usually, like, you know, because you burn meter with the, oh goodness, because you burn meter with the V trigger, yeah, wouldn't you just do like grabs and stuff, because you don't really burn meter with grabs, with command grabs?
Yeah, you don't burn meter with grabs, definitely. I mean, the grabs, like, I actually aim for the grabs, because then obviously it doesn't burn meter and it does a chunk of damage and chunk of stun, but you have to instill that into them, you know, like, you have to put them into enough frame traps to set up for it. You know, just like anchor them when they get up, like stand leg kick or cross and jab, keep them grounded, and then you hit them with a surprise command grab. You hit them with a surprise EX command grab, it does like a shit ton of damage, and they're like, oh shit, I gotta get out of here. And they get up, that's when you get a free raw headbutt, because they're trying to run away.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, that's pretty much like the setup. You put them in shock, then their next action is like, it's really predictable. That's the thing, that he has a really strong sequence the moment he activates V-trigger when he combos you. Because then it makes you preemptively do a defensive action. You can't wait. If you wait too long, you get command grab. But if you act too early, you get headbutted. You know what I mean?
Nah, definitely. I agree with you. You know, we were talking earlier on about Zangief. I'm pretty much losing to a Zangief player right now, you know. This Zangief player has been giving me problems. Problems. I don't understand, like, why this is happening right now. But
what's he doing?
It's like he just knows when to, like he's breaking the bananas with the V skill that he has. But then he's holding on to it, so anytime I try to do anything like jab or anything like that, it's still counting as like armor. And then like he's just grabbing me. He just knows when I'm gonna jump. It's ridiculous. Like, this is the only Zangief player that has been giving me problems like for the past week.
Yeah,
anytime I find him in rank, it's like, it's just, I get scared.
Have you played with him before, or?
No, I just catch him in rank. He's a really good, he's a really good Zangief player. There we go. Yeah, he's really, really good. You go on.
I mean, if the Zangief player is catching on some really good reads like that, I mean, either you guys played enough in the past and he has a really good understanding of what you're doing, or
he just knows what I'm going to jump.
Actions are paying out a lot. Like, are you jumping back, jumping up, jumping forward?
So, like, when he gets close, like, he's SPDing me now, like, I don't want to jump. And then when I don't jump, he, yeah, see, he would just come on, grab me. Look, here we go. It's like he knows when. It doesn't make any sense. Like, when I'm jumping, he just knows.
Sometimes it happens, man. Like, sometimes he's got them reads.
Nah, he has them reads. Oh, my dick. This doesn't make any sense. It's just one Zangief player, you know. I rarely lose to Zangief. Very, very rarely. And this is one Zangief player that has been just giving me problems. I don't know what to do, man.
That's what I kind of feel like when I do fight Zangief, and when I do get in trouble, it's like all the reads are just correct, and I feel like that's just how the round goes. If I were to mess up and he's in the range, I kind of just have to accept that I'm probably gonna die.
Yeah, you know, like that. It's crazy, man. Uh oh.
But I mean, like, that's the only thing that's got going for Zangief, though, right? He needs to, like, get in that range to knock you down, and it's pretty much ST Geef when he gets close.
Yep. There we go. 1-1. Sorry. I got proper carried away with that one. So, like, yeah, so other things as well that I wanted to talk to you about is, shout-outs to the follower as well. The other thing I wanted to talk to you about as well is pretty much, do you ever see yourself dropping birdie when the other characters come out? And what I mean by the other characters, I mean, like, you know, you got the DLC pack this year, and then obviously next year they're going to release like a certain amount of characters again. Do you see yourself putting birdie on the back seat, or would you always use birdie as your main character?
I feel like I've invested so much time in the birdie that he's always going to be my go-to character.
Yeah.
I would definitely start me until I find like a better birdie. You know what I mean? Like, unless I can find another character who does just like what he does or better, then sure, I'll probably switch. But I mean, I'm not like a good character necessarily. But I mean, I really like everything about him. Like his character design, what he does, his style. It's like I like characters who have a lot of power, speed, trickery. I mean, I'm into all that stuff. If there's another character like that, then there's a good chance that I'll drop birdie for that. But not really seeing that happening anytime soon.
I see that you've picked Alex up. Would you say Alex is a better version of birdie in terms of like everything that he has, or would you say they're two different characters?
They're definitely two separate entities. I mean, a lot of people are saying, you know, birdie's a better Alex. Alex is a better birdie. I think they're both one and the same. Like, they have similar game plans, I would say, in certain matchups. Offensively, yes, same game plan. Defensively, maybe a little different. I mean, obviously, one has projectiles, you know, the bananas, the cans.
Yeah.
The other one has a defensive parry. But I think they both go well in hand with one another. But I would never necessarily choose one over the other.
Nah,
really, honestly. Like, do I want to play Alex or I want to play Birdie? Yeah.
So, I heard that. I definitely heard that. When Alex came out and I see that people are playing him, I always thought that Alex was the better version of Birdie. Oh, for fuck's sake.
Alex is a pretty strong character. I mean, definitely underrated.
His forward hard punch is really good. It really keeps people like, it keeps me scared. Anytime I see Alex and he's got me back against the wall, forward hard punch, it's like, okay, well, I don't want to jump. I don't want to press a button because he's plus three. It's just like, it's very dangerous. Alex has got a very dangerous game, but then again, Birdie has a very dangerous game as well. So
yeah, I mean, the thing about birdie versus Alex, especially when he starts swinging that fourth pierce,
yeah,
you really have to just weigh your options at that point. Like, are you willing to take a throw, or are you willing to take a crush counter, increase your stun bar like by X amount if he has V trigger and everything, right? At that point, if he has V trigger stocked up and he's swinging, it's probably better just to block and take the command throw. Because what, he only has one follow-up afterwards, right? Or two? Either the meaty elbow or dash up. But the dash up is negative, though. That's the problem with him. That his post-mix-up games are pretty linear.
Yeah.
But I think some characters could actually just wake up and crouch-block, and he will dodge the fourth fierce, I think.
No, so, I hear that. I definitely.
I think some characters or all characters. I'm not sure. I don't remember.
So, I know you said Birdie's your primary, but who would you say is better, Birdie or Alex?
That's very, that's debatable. Definitely very subjective.
There could only be one, man. It's either it's one or the other, man. I feel like I would really believe
in one. Clearly, that's why I play so many characters, but it's tough. Like right now, maybe it's too early because there's not enough sample size for Alex players,
yeah,
especially in the major circuit. But I think down the road, Alex will be better.
See, this is what I'm saying, man.
Down the road, though, like a long way. Because right now, there's not enough like technology being discovered, right? Like Birdie, right now everybody's kind of like, oh, that's it. Birdie can do that, whatever. But Alex, though, he has some untapped potential because then when Alex first came out, everybody's like, oh, he's stubby, blah, 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 I can't do this. And then all these videos coming out, like these like one-hit kill stun combos and shit like that. And I mean, you get really creative with Alex.
Yeah.
But at the same time, if you narrow it down just to the raw mechanic of the game, he has some really good factors. Like he has a 2-frame parry. His stun rate is really high on his combos. He has some really good frame traps.
Yeah.
Once he gets you in that blender, you know what I mean? It's not like a Mika blender where, you know, it's pretty much automatic. But the reward for the Alex Vortex is incredibly high. It's like crazy. It's like a train. You get it started and you're in trouble.
Nah, definitely.
Even if you have an invisible reversal, doesn't matter because that creates another mix-up, right? Because wake up, either you block, jump, or you know tech. And if you have DP, that's a fourth option for Alex to block. If he blocks that, he kills you. So the fact that he could kill you, because then you want to wake a reversal with a DP or EX bird kick, that kind of almost eliminates the option for your opponent really, automatically.
Definitely. Seeing as you're speaking about Mika, yeah, I just wanted to ask a question. What do you think of that character?
I hate her.
Join the party, man.
Like, she's completely retarded. I'm not trying to, like, discredit the players or anything, but the character pretty much carries it herself. Like, it's ridiculous.
I agree.
She's not like you. You can take some, you know, some skills or whatnot, but she's like an Elena plus Yoon. It's like automatic. It's like that powerful. You know what I mean?
No, I agree.
Like,
I agree.
She has an assist. She has very advantageous moves. She has one button that pretty much triggers the whole round.
No, it's true.
Like that's a really, how to explain it? That's a really unfair button. Considering the startup on it, the range, how active it is, and the potential for it, I'm not quite sure why Capcom decided to make the Ice Whip wall bounce mid screen again. I felt like it was perfectly fine when it was only corner.
It's true.
Then you know, it would, you know, create a more, or it would condone more solid play and strategy rather than like wake up, clap, you're in the corner, right? It's like you pretty much just transported your opponent to the corner, and obviously, when she's in the corner against you, that's like a really bad ratio. Like, you can't win in the corner against her. She's probably, if not the best character in the corner right now, regardless of resources.
That's true. I agree. So what do you think about, like, alright, so the Irish whip is really bad. What about, like, when your back's against the walls? Well, I think that's something that I just think a lot of people just, oh, go. Like I was saying, you see when she got you, like, in the corner and she got all of those setups, don't you think that's a bit unfair?
Yeah, I mean, it's like, it's too much. It's like an army, you know, like, it's like a group versus one person. It has all that meter, V-trigger, super meter. It's crazy. Even, like, her V-reverse is really good. It gives her advantage.
That's what I'm saying. It's, like, it's really, really good.
It's kind of unfair.
It's really, really unfair. Oh, man. A guy says in here, Mattism says, does it make sense to get birdie in V-trigger ace as soon as possible instead of combos into it? What's your thoughts on that?
I'm going to go back to say it's very circumstantial. Depending on how far in the round you are against the opponent you're playing. I'll give an example. Say if you're fighting against Ken, right? And say you have, I don't know, 70% likely against Ken, and he has like 20%. He has 50% as well. And you have an opportunity to combo into it, but it might give him the V-trigger. When Ken gets V-trigger, you know what's going to happen. Crouching medium plunge, confirm. Low four fireball, confirm. EX fireball, confirm. So it becomes really risky to fight against him at that point. I would opt to, say, save the V-trigger at that point, just to knock him back when he gets in. Because once he gets in, it can get pretty tough. You know, he has, like, really tight frame traps.
Yeah.
So I would say save that until you're ready for a kill combo at that point. But generally, in most matchups, people right now, including myself, if I see it, you know, I hit the EX, I activate it. You know, that seems to be, like, the general thing for everybody in the game. When you have V-trigger, people try to go for it right away. Like Chun-Li, the moment she has V-trigger, slide. Karen, roundhouse. Mika, down fierce, right? And, like, every other character. Nakali does the stand roundhouse, low forward, right into V-trigger. Everybody is very anxious to go for it. But yeah. I like to think that the best way to do it is to save it for, like, a kill combo or close to stun. Kind of like in Tekken, right?
Yeah.
When you know your opponent is really close to rage if you were to hit this one combo. So instead, you would shorten that combo so they're just outside of the borders to get rage. And if the next hit you do, next hit you land on them, you convert it to a kill. So it bypasses that. So they don't get the level up.
Okay, I didn't know you played Tekken. You didn't tell me.
I play a little bit.
You didn't tell me you played Tekken.
I don't tell anybody that.
So what you are you interested in Tekken 7?
I played Tekken 7 a little bit a couple months ago. It's very interesting. I mean, it looks fun. It's not like the old Tekken. But I could definitely see myself playing it. I don't know if I'll play it competitively yet. Because I don't really have a big scene over here. Or anybody to really play against, so that could be troublesome. But definitely, it sparks my interest.
Okay, definitely. I'm having trouble with this Laura at the minute, man.
Oh, no, Laura.
She's really... Uh-oh. See what I'm saying? You know what problem that I have with this character as well, with Birdie, is that when you do, like, the EX Bullhorn, it's like, sometimes when you're just, when you get, like, reset and you just land, it's like, the EX Bullhorn doesn't come out. Do you ever get that problem come out at all?
Yes. I think, I don't know if it's a glitch in the game or not. I remember it was discussed somewhere that to get, like, a reversal timing EX Bullhorn,
yeah,
after certain scenarios, it is very tight. So it's not like, there's not much leeway for it. So for me, I actually have to hold, like, multiple buttons, multiple combinations, just in case.
Serious?
Yeah, it's weird because sometimes it just doesn't come out. Sometimes a regular one comes out, and that's even worse.
Yeah.
You get like counter hit, right?
Yeah.
But there's a good chance that when you do release the EX version, nothing comes out, and your character's just standing there. Gate crash, and then you get hit.
Okay, yeah, because this Laura play that was a super platinum, I literally landed. I was holding on to L1 on my pad, and literally I let it go, and I just stood there.
Yeah, that's weird. I don't know, man. Like, something's going on with the button combinations for that.
It just really didn't make any sense to me. I was just like, wow. Oh yeah, you say you gotta go off in the next. You gotta go off in the next 8 minutes, isn't it?
What's that?
You gotta head off in the next 8 minutes.
Yeah, I got about a good 8 minutes to discuss whatever you want, man.
All right. So in the stream chat, there's people in the stream chat. If there's anything you wanna ask LPN, make sure you lot ask me right now so we can get the questions done. I'm really having trouble with this. Like, just certain characters with like. All right. So you see, like, Birdie versus. So we spoke about Birdie versus Rashid earlier on. We spoke about Birdie versus Chun Li. We spoke a bit about that, but we didn't touch fully on that. Like, okay, so a good Chun Li player, do you find yourself like struggling against them? Obviously, that's a silly question, but do you find yourself really, really like, is it really unbeatable? Do you reckon?
I don't think it's unbeatable. That's the thing with Birdie. Matchups for him are unbeatable.
Yeah.
And that's why I feel like he requires a longer set, especially against like random players, you know, like brand new players, right? I really feel like he's how to explain it. He just requires to get intel on the opponent. And, you know, the longer the fight, the better for him.
Yeah.
In the short term, 2 out of 3 against Chun Li is really hard because she's just stand fierce, you're the death, fireball, stand fierce, and he's like, I haven't really figured out how to get around this character. Maybe I could beat the player instead. But at that point, it's only 2 out of 3. You won't be able to get that much, you know, tendencies out of the player because they're literally just pressing 1 or 2 buttons, right? And
yeah.
That's just character, not player. So you don't really get a chance to open up like their defensive tendencies or whatnot. Their offense is just purely character. Defense is purely player. And you need to get that information, right? Once you get that information, that's when Birdie starts getting the damage in. You know, getting the command grabs, getting the sweep crush counters, getting the nice jump ins, and all that stuff. And it requires, you know, a longer set than 2 out of 3.
I agree.
If you in the 2 out of 3, sometimes if you want to beat Chun Li, you just gotta go wild and just hope for the best, right?
Yeah, I agree. So how would you approach that match then? Like what would be the things you wouldn't do, and what would be the things you would do?
Things against Chun Li, certain range, you cannot use V skill because she has good mobility and she could just walk up and just punch you. So that kind of sucks. Definitely save my EX meter for low 4 fireball strings.
Yeah.
That's going to be your entry point. Especially at V trigger too. Once you have V trigger, you have to kill her. Regardless if she has super or not, or V reverse or whatever, you have to kill her. And I always bait the EX bird kick. No matter what, because I know that's where the root of all my damage is going to be. I'm going to take out at least a third of her life in one combo.
I understand. Yeah, no, so I agree.
Definitely bait that. And again, standing fierce and standing roundhouse, I would use crouching medium punch to lower my profile and whip punish those buttons. But I would use it sparingly. And that's going to be another entry point for me. Pretty much, the best way to play against her is just counteract.
Counteract, yeah.
Just wait and counter. Wait and counter.
Okay, fair enough. And you think using the V-trigger would be wise rather than saving... Because I usually think to just save the V-guard and just keep on V-reversaling when I get into a sticky situation. But
definitely against her, because she has really good pressure with the air legs and the one frame block strings, you know, from the low, the standing. Saving V reversal can only get you so far.
Yeah.
I would definitely opt to save the V reversal when she has V trigger activated or close to it, because you're going to need to get her off you. And the good thing about it is because multiple hits, you can just push it out, right? But if she doesn't have it, then I'm gonna just activate V trigger, combo her. I'm pretty sure that one combo will probably give her a full V trigger anyways.
Yeah.
So at that point, like, there's no way you can, like, bait it out or, you know, trick her. She's gonna get it no matter what. It's like one of those matchups. You do too much damage to them, they're gonna get that much stronger. It's like fighting the Cali too. Like, there's no point of, like, trying to strategize around his V trigger because he's gonna get it no matter what. Hit or get hit, he's gonna get it.
Yeah. Nah, I like that way of thinking, man. I definitely like that way of thinking, man. All right, cool. So to wrap this up, have you got any social medias or Twitch or anything like that you want to like to give out to the stream?
Oh yeah, definitely. If you guys haven't followed me yet, follow me at Circa_LPN. That's CIRCA_LPN. That's where you guys find me on the social medias for Twitter. I'll be posting some funny stuff. Probably watching fire all day long.
Nice.
If you guys want to check out my my stream channel, it's gonna be Pandora House. Twitch.tv/Pandora House. I'm trying to stream more nowadays because I have more time, and I actually just started streaming again yesterday. It's really fun. Definitely come by, you know, chat about anything and everything. Really fun. And yeah, I mean, check it out, guys.
All right, man, definitely. One more thing I want to ask you about. You're a part of a team, but I've looked into it, but I don't know too much. Could you tell us about the team that you're part of? Because I recently seen that a Tekken player named Anakin joined the same team. So I just wanted to know a bit more.
I just recently joined Circuit Esports. They're fairly new. I believe they've been around for a little over a year now. And pretty much their mission right now is to get a collective of really strong players in different divisions. As you can see, they added me for Street Fighter V. They added Anakin for Tekken recently. And I believe they have a player for Pokken, Suicune Master.
Oh wow!
Up there, he's really good. Definitely.
I see.
Right now, we're pretty much preparing for the esports war. I always call it.
It seems that way. I see that they've got a Counter-Strike team as well, which is like they're not even just going for fighting games; they're getting for other genre games as well, which is really good.
Yeah, definitely. It's a multi-platform esports team, so that's really good. A lot of diversity, variety, and you know we want to cover all of the grounds right now because you know esports definitely is booming. For the FGC, because you know we're going through a transition, right? And of course, a lot of sponsors and other companies want to get invested into it. Like I'm pretty sure you guys heard about like Bud Light recently. They're doing that All-Star vote thing, and I know there's some other sports team like Rick Fox. He just recently got into the fighting game department and more esports teams.
Oh, swear!
And I mean, like this year, it's been pretty crazy. Like esports everywhere, man. It's like it's booming. It's happening.
It's happening, so man.
Right now, we're pretty much getting ready.
Wicked. Awesome, man. Well, that's been LPN. Thank you very much, man, for, you know, supporting the stream and, that, you know, coming on board and talking to me, man. I really, really appreciate it, man.
It's a pleasure, man. Thanks for inviting me.
No, thank you very much, man. And, you know, hopefully, you know, I might fly out to American tournament and, you know, we can share some more tech, man. Don't know if it says it's on hold. I don't know what happened to him. I don't know if that's a connection issue.
Alright, man, I'm gonna head out actually. It was definitely nice talking to you guys. Hopefully it was very informative. And of course, keep supporting the stream. Check out King J when you guys get a chance.
Alright, thank you very much, man.
Alright, man, take it easy, guys.
Alright, peace, man.
Peace.
Alright, guys, that was LPN from